So, what's up, guys? This is a video that I've really, really have been dreading to do. One, because it concerns a terrorist attack, and two, because it will most likely be seen as controversial, especially to many people. Particularly to people in France. But a lot of this has to be said. Now, before I get to any of the controversy surrounding this, many of you probably already know what I'm about to speak on, and many of you most likely have been hearing about the attacks that have happened in Paris. Now, the bulk of these attacks happened at the Bataclan Theater in downtown Paris, where there was a Eagles of Death metal concert that was going on, and about 120 plus people. I think the last time I checked, the death toll was like 129, and supposedly these attacks were carried out by the Islamic State. And so far there has been at least, as I've recalled, at least three people that were arrested, but there was about eight suspects. Many of these people were arrested in a Belgian area. Other things that have been connected to this have been a camp that was in Calais, and this has just been a very devastating attack. This is basically France's equivalent to the British 7/7 and to America's 9/11 and to the Madrid bombings a few years back as well. Now, all I can really say about this attack, yes, it was a horrible atrocity committed by a fundamentalist group of people, by a group of fucking narcissistic extremists with a zealotous sort of, fascist ideology, as well as the fact that many of the people that fight for them are fucking first-worldist Western teenagers and young adults with, that just really, I'm not going to get into that. I'm just basically going to state the fact that this does appear to have been pulled off by ISIS. Now, one of the problem, now, before I, again, before I get into the controversy, let me also address this issue. The French President, François Hollande, has called this an act of war, which I find interesting considering that France has already technically been at war with, helping fight, Al-Qaeda and other groups, and was also behind, helping the US and other Western imperialists give arms to the Free Syrian Army, in which ISIS was originally spawned from the beginning. But the point being is that he's called this an act of war, and this is definitely a hostile act that has been perpetrated against his nation. So, yes, I understand. However, what I also have been finding has been the tremendous reactionary sentiment regarding Islamophobia. There's been a tremendous amount of Islamophobia coming from a lot of people in France. Justly, a lot of people say this is justified, given that this was pulled off by a group of Muslim extremists, by a group of Arabs. But the problem that people don't understand is that terrorism has no religion. Terrorism is not linked to just one religion. In fact, the more often than not, people that carry out attacks in the name of religion have been Christians and Catholics. One of the most heinous genocides being committed by in the name of a Abrahamic faith is in Judaism, with the Israeli Jewish nationalists, the Zionists, attacking Palestinians. Because Zionism itself is a fascist ideology. It is an ultra-nationalistic ideology based on the idea that you have a divine right to rule and control that area. And that is one of the things that has been occurring since 1947, actually 1946, considering the King David Hotel bombing. There's been a lot of different attacks going on there, but people completely ignore that. People completely ignore the genocide going on in Palestine. They completely ignore the continuous, the erroneous and continuous attacks by ISIS on Muslims within Syria and Iraq. 100,000 Muslims have died at the hands of the Islamic State. I say Islamic in quotations because this is not an Islamic group of people. The higher-ups are Islamic fundamentals. Al-Baghdadi himself is an Islamic fundamental. To be honest, I don't even think that they're Islamic fundamental. I just think they're a bunch of assholes on a power trip. That they're just a group of fucking thugs going around and mercilessly killing people. I mean, when you consider that at least 60 fucking percent of their damn fighting force is a bunch of fucking foreign mercenaries from like France and Germany and, you know, the Balkans and from even the US. And people from Brazil and Colombia and other places like that who are fighting with this group of numbskulls. It's not an Islamic group. The fact that they call it an Islamic state is a fucking joke. They're a bunch of fucking thugs. Oh, and by the way, the fact that they're actually now creating their own hashtags and boasting about it on social media, guess what? You lose your legitimacy as a terrorist organization when you begin fighting the infidels using fucking Facebook and Twitter. And to add insult to injury, to use hashtags to carry out and boast about your attacks, you're not a terrorist organization. You're a group of fucking pussies. Go fuck yourselves. That's what really needs to be said here. And yes, there's a reason why I'm going after them too. Of course I'm going to go after ISIS. They're a group of fascist individuals. I'm a Marxist. I hate fascism. I think that the whole idea of the Islamic State, I don't fear the Islamic State. I think it's a fucking joke. Granted, I think that the whole idea of Marxism right now in the First World, I think that's a fucking joke. I mean, literally, you could kill that in a heartbeat. In fact, you could probably kill 50% of ISIS now by just cutting off Facebook and everything else for a couple of days. I mean, seriously, if you just cut off the internet service to them over there, they would be done. Half of their organization would be gone. And the fact that 90% of their damn fleet, which is nothing but friggin' jeeps and shit like that, has been destroyed by Russia in a single day... You're a pathetic organization. These are not individuals to be feared. They're people that should be mocked and laughed at. It's like, yes, they just pulled off a horrendous fucking attack. But do you know why? Because they're fucking desperate. They're fucking moronic. And they're heartless, frankly. That's clear as day. But they're desperate because this is because their only means of trying to bring about jihad and bring about some sort of, you know, which that itself is a fucking joke, to bring about some sort of, they're trying to bring about some sort of revolution and stuff like that. They think they're bringing about some revolution. No, they're bringing about reactionism. That's all they're bringing about. And what they're really doing is trying to turn and my personal theory, they're trying to turn the Western world against Arab people. Think about that for a second. Why would an organization built on, I would say, with a small minority, built on this idea of Arab nationalism and a fascist ideology, why would they be trying so hard to have foreign kids come fight for their fascist ideology and bring about some sort, you know, bring about this fear and intimidation to turn the Western world to fascism? Because they want, if they wanted to actually turn the world to fascism, this would probably be the most ingenious fucking method that they could go about it, to carry out bombings, to carry out all this sort of attacks. This sort of BS is exactly what they're trying to accomplish. My theory is they're trying to create this element that they are a Islamic fundamentalist state, carry out these attacks to turn people against Islam, to turn people against Arabs, to continue this fascist thought, to turn the rest of the Western world towards fascism. And they're doing a pretty goddamn good job at it. Look at the rise in Europe of neo-Nazism, Nazbolism, and the white supremacist and other ultra-nationalistic and fascist ideologies. Look at the rise. Golden Dawn is looking to be become more of a fucking power in Greece than Syriza ever could. Golden Dawn is literally barking at the door, waiting for the opportunity to strike. And according to a recent thing that I found, because I was listening to Jason Unruh recently, 67% of people would be willing to turn their countries over to basically unelected leaders, to technocrats. Again, unelected they're talking about fascism. I was just talking to a person that ended up blocking me on Instagram the other day. You know, I don't know why? Because I was arguing with him about Front National. Yeah. This dumbass literally was claiming that Front National could save France. Really? Have you not learned what fascism has done to Europe, especially to the nation of France? Do you remember the millions of people that were killed in Europe? Hundreds of thousands of French people sent to their deaths or facing death at the hands of fascist forces. And you want to bring Front National, a fascist organization led by the insanity of Marie Le Pen, to power? Are you fucking insane? I understand why. Because an attack just happened in your city. You're pissed. You're so gung-ho against Islamic people right now and against Arab people that you somehow think this is Islamophobia is somehow justified. Oh, by the way, this was France Ball on Instagram. You literally think that fascism can save France? You want to go back to that mass slaughter of people? And not only, you know, the fact that you want to go back to that horrendous time that killed tens of millions of people. Now, I'm not talking about the Holocaust. I'm talking about actual people that went to their deaths in war to stop fascism. You want to go back to that? You want to go back to that ultra-nationalistic, ultra-militaristic sort of idea, white supremacist ideology, that Eurocentrism? Really? It's not just also the Islamophobia. It's also the fact that Front National and these groups are anti-Semitic. These people hate Jewish people. They don't just want to expel the Arabs. They want to quite literally get rid of the Jews. They literally talk about Hitler. Franz Ball himself was praising Hitler on Instagram, and he blocks me because I happen to, you know my history and know what fascism did, and I don't want that to return. That's why I speak out on it. And yet, people are actually willing to turn their country over to fascism. And with a French election soon coming, that could be very possible. Marie, like Golden Dawn, Marie Le Pen and her Front National group are literally barking at the doors because let's be honest, the I forgot what the president's name before Hollande one was, people have realized that basically capitalism hasn't worked in their country, very distinctly. In a different manner. Instead of economic, this has been politically motivated, this has been religiously motivated. So much like Greece, in the sense of politics and religion, as opposed to Greece's economic issues, we see the same issue. People couldn't trust the conservative capitalist government. They couldn't trust the socialist, the social democratic government of Francois Hollande. And now, because of these attacks, people think that their only alternative is fascism. They literally think that the only saving grace is fascism, not realizing that that is exactly what's going to drive them to their demise. That's going to drive Europe to its demise. That's going to drive the Western world to its demise. They don't even realize the severity of these situations. And of course, this Islamophobia is fast spreading. Look at how fast it's spreading across the West. Not only just in France, but the U.S. as well, with Islamophobic sentiment rising across the country. I don't know how many times I've actually had to have arguments and had to debunk people and literally have been spending my weekend literally trying to calm people down. I've had to share numerous posts on social media trying to calm people down. And I've gotten into arguments with people this weekend to the point where my brain has literally wanted to explode. I find it's kind of one of those things. You can lead a horse to water, but you can't make him drink. You can lead a person to knowledge, but you can't make them think. And I have done everything I can to get people to realize that this Islamophobic sentiment is not necessary. It's not justified. Even in the wake of this French terrorist attack, there's no sentiment for it. You know why? Because 90% of Muslims around the world have been condemning the attacks. People all over the world of Muslim faith and of Arab descent have been condemning these attacks because they are an immense atrocity. They make Arabs and Muslims look bad. And that's exactly what the Islamic State wants. This quasi-Islamic group, this neo-fascist organization is trying to stir up Islamophobic sentiment to turn the world against people, to turn the world towards fascism. They want to turn the world against the Arab world because they want their own state. It's Arab. It's built on Arab nationalism. They want their own Arab state. They want a pan-Arab nationalist state. That's why, and in order to do that, they have to get that Western influence out. So what are they? How do they do that? They're going about it by turning the sentiment of the people against the Arabs, so that they can end up, so that basically the Western imperialists get their influence. Basically, the people say, we don't want to be there, you know, and if we are going to be there, let's destroy them. You know, to focus on their state itself. It's literally this combination of neo-fascism and isolationism built in with the contradictions of imperialism. That's exactly what this problem is. All I can say is this. People are trying to blame the refugees. But the refugees, but the people that are the refugees, quite a few of these people that have carried out these attacks are literally French citizens. So how can you necessarily, you know, be bitching about refugees when these people are French? It doesn't make any fucking sense. These people that carried out the attacks had all the necessary paperwork. They were not illegal immigrants. They were not refugees. They were people posing as refugees. They were people that were, they were French nationals who posed as refugees. Again, this all goes back to the idea of French people going to fight for this crappy organization, this quasi-Islamic organization. Again, they're not Islamic. They're quasi-Islamic. They're neo-fascists who are trying to stir up this anti-Islamic, anti-Arab sentiment. And they came through Greece to do so. And that these people were French nationals. Some of these people were French nationals. So that right there says something about it as well. And it's the same thing when it comes down to the people that committed the attacks in Britain and in Spain and even the 9/11 attacks. These were perpetrated by, and even people, the Boston bombers, these were people that had legal documentation. They had all the legal paperwork down to get into the country. They didn't just sneak in there. They had all the legal paperwork necessary to pass the checkpoints. So it's not necessarily an issue with immigration. It's not an issue about a particular ideology or a fundamentalist religious thing. It has more to do with the fact that people, that it has more to do with the fact that sometimes shit just happens, you know. But of course, we always need to look for a certain group of people to blame. We always need a boogeyman to basically be hammering at in some fashion. Yes, we should be pissed at the people that committed this atrocity, which is ISIS. We should be pissed about that. But let us not forget that there are people that die every fucking day in Palestine and in Syria and Nigeria and Libya. That people who die every day of starvation and thirst, or dying from parasites because their water is not drinkable. People that die at the hands of U.S. imperialism, from U.S. drone strikes due to that sort of imperialism. People are dying every day in these war-torn or third-world countries, but as soon as something happens in Paris, all of a sudden that's a big deal, but we're just going to ignore the genocides and the mass killings of other people in other countries. We're going to just ignore the 100,000 Islamic people that ISIS has destroyed, that the even the historical artifacts and historical sites that ISIS is destroying. And no one gives a shit about that. But an attack goes off at Bataclan, and all of a sudden, it's just worldwide news. Don't get it twisted. 129 people are dead. Maybe more at this point. And my heart goes out to those families. I do believe that people should stand by the people of Paris, and that they should definitely, that they should be giving some sort of, give them your sympathies and everything like that. But instead of changing your goddamn profile pictures, how about actually donate some money to charity or help these people in some way, or, give them some sort of medical aid or something. Actually get off your butt and do something. Don't just say, oh, I stand with Paris, I changed my profile picture. That social media BS is meaningless. So, basically what I'm trying to say here is, this was a horrible tragedy. It was committed by a group of quasi-Islamics, neo-fascists, but frankly, the Islamophobia is just not worth, it's not justified, it's not worth it, it's not worth getting yourself worked up over. And to the people of France, my heart is with you. My heart goes out to the families of the victims. I'm very sorry for your losses. But please do not let these events turn your faith away from what you at least have currently. Do not let it turn you towards fascism. For the love of all that is fucking holy, listen to your collective conscience. Have common sense. Do not let this turn you into some sort of monster. Do not let this event turn France and Europe over and the Western world over to fascism. And this too goes to Europe and to the Western world. I'm NorCal Nick, leader of the revolutionist movement, and this has been NorCal Corner. Stay safe, y'all.
You never really can fix my heart.